Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Ajala Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject gas power cycles. So this is lecture number 4. The topic is gas turbine cycle. We are going to discuss about the Brayton cycle. So the topic for this lecture, so Brayton cycle, maximum work output and efficiency of the Brayton cycle, simple Brayton cycle, effect of friction on turbine and compressor. So we recap from the previous lectures. So in the previous lecture we studied about the Otto cycle, diesel cycle, dual cycle, and we derived the efficiency, work output, mean effective pressure of the three cycles. And we compared the three cycles, Otto cycle, diesel cycle and dual cycle. And the learning outcome for this lecture. So at the end of this lecture, the student will be able to explain the Brayton cycle, derive the expression for maximum work output and maximum efficiency of Brayton cycle. And the student will be able to discuss the effect of friction of turbine and compressor on efficiency of the Brayton cycle. And all the learning outcome, they are coming under L2, that is understanding level, level 2 of the Bloom's taxonomy. And this Brayton cycle is the basic cycle for gas turbine power plant. And the cycle first proposed by George Brayton in the year 1870. And the open cycle gas turbine. So this is the, after invention of the rotary compressor and rotary turbine, we started to build the open cycle gas turbine, so to produce mechanical power. So the fresh air from the atmosphere, it is consumed, it is taken by the compressor, admitted into the compressor, it is compressed to a higher pressure. The compressor is driven by the turbine, so the work required for compressing the air is taken from the turbine, and the high pressure air supplied to the combustion chamber. So in the combustion chamber, so the fuel is injected. So the fuel may be liquid fuel, gaseous fuel, or sometimes solid fuel like pulverized coal, powdered form of coal. And the majority of the cases, we are supplying only liquid fuel or gaseous fuel, depending on the availability. Solid fuel like pulverized coal is the rarest opportunity, rarest possibility. And by burning the fuel, the hot gases are produced. Then the hot gases with the higher pressure and temperature and the enthalpy, they are supplied to the gas turbine. So in the gas turbine, the gases are expanded. So by expanding the gas, we produce power. So the power is used by the compressor. Nearly 2/3 of the power is used to drive the compressor. Remaining 1/3 power is available as a net work output for power generation. So after expansion, the hot gases are led to the atmosphere. So this is open cycle where we can burn the fuel in the combustion chamber. But for the cycle analysis, to derive the efficiency and to calculate the parameter of the gas turbine power plant, we take a hypothetical cycle. So closed cycle gas turbine. So instead of a combustion chamber, now there is a heat exchanger where we supply heat energy from outside. So the compressor is taking the air. So it is air turbine or any other gas without combustion. So the air is compressed to a higher pressure by the compressor, and the air goes to the heat exchanger where heat is added to the air. So from external source, the burning is taking place outside, so the heat is supplied to the air. So the hot air from the heat exchanger entering into the turbine. So in the turbine, the work is produced by the air, hot air, by expanding hot air to a lower temperature, lower enthalpy, work is produced. And the work is used for driving the compressor. As we told earlier, nearly 2/3 of the work is used by the compressor. Remaining 1/3 of the work is available for external power generation. And the gas turbine, the air turbine, the air at the outlet of the turbine, it is cooled now. So, the heat is removed here. So, the heat is removed and it is cooled air is recirculated back to the compressor. Now, here there are 4 processes in the cycle, Brayton cycle, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1. So, 1 to 2 is compression process. So, the compression is isentropic compression process. So, reversible adiabatic or isentropic compression process. 2 to 3 is constant pressure heat addition process. 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion process, constant entropy expansion process, and 4 to 1 it is again constant pressure heat removal process. So, there is one heat addition, one heat removal, one work input and one work output. The 4 processes, they are given in the pressure volume and temperature entropy diagram. So, 1 to 2 is isentropic compression where the pressure increases, and we prepare the table. With the help of the table, we try to explain the Brayton cycle, simple Brayton cycle. 1 to 2 isentropic compression where the pressure increases, volume decreases. Because of the compression, temperature increases and the entropy remains constant. And 2 to 3 is constant, reversible constant pressure heat addition. So, pressure remains constant, volume increases, look at the volume V2 to V3. And because of the heat addition, temperature increases and entropy is also increasing because of the heat transfer. Then 3 to 4 isentropic expansion. So, expansion process. So, pressure decreases, volume increases because of the expansion, volume increases, temperature decreases because expansion 3 to 4 and the entropy remains constant. And 4 to 1 reversible constant pressure heat rejection. So, pressure remains constant and volume decreases. Look at the PV diagram, 4 to 1 volume decreases and the temperature decreases because of the heat removal. And entropy is also decreasing because of the heat removal. So, all the 4 processes are given in the table and in the PV and TS coordinates. So, with the help of the table, you can explain the operation of the cycle, working of the cycle. And we have to calculate the efficiency of the Brayton cycle. So, for that, we have to calculate the heat supplied, QS equal to MCP into T3 minus T2. So, the heat is supplied at constant pressure. Heat is rejected at constant pressure again. So, QR, heat rejected equal to MCP into T4 minus T1. And the efficiency of the Brayton cycle, efficiency of any thermodynamic cycle is net work done divided by the heat supplied. So, from the first law of thermodynamics, net work done equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by heat supplied equal to 1 minus QR by QS. We substitute QR and QS from the previous expressions. So, 1 minus MCP into T4 minus T1 divided by MCP into T3 minus T2. So, MCP is getting cancelled. So, finally, 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2. And in the next equation, we take, in the numerator, we take T1 outside. So, 1 minus T1 into T4 by T1 minus 1. And divided by T2, we take in the denominator T2 outside, T2 into T3 by T2 minus 1, which is equal to 1 minus T1 by T2, because these two are equal, we will verify. So, the T4 by T1 minus 1 is equal to T3 by T2 minus 1, they are equal. So, finally, the equation is eta B, Brayton cycle efficiency equal to 1 minus T1 by T2. Now, look at the other side. So, for isentropic compression and expansion, so for compression process, T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, here P2 by P1 equal to the pressure ratio of the compression process. So, RP, pressure ratio to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Similarly, T3 by T4 for isentropic expansion, T3 by T4 equal to P3 by P4 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. And from the PV diagram, we come to know that P3 equal to P2 and P4 equal to P1. So, that is also equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, finally, these two equations are equal. So, T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T4 equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, we take the first two terms, T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T4. So, we rearrange by cross multiplying. We rearrange T4 by T1 equal to T3 by T2. So, we subtract 1 from both sides. So, T4 by T1 minus 1 equal to T3 by T2 minus 1. So, mathematically, this will give the same result. Now, that is why we removed T4 by T1 minus 1 and T3 by T2 minus 1. So, finally, the Benetton cycle efficiency equal to 1 minus T1 by T2. So, we take eta b equal to 1 minus T1 by T2 is equal to 1 minus, I take T1 to the denominator, so T2 by T1, which is 1 minus 1 by P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus by gamma. So, we in this previous slide, we derived P2 by P1 equal to, so T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, using this expression, so the efficiency of Benetton cycle equal to 1 minus 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. And this equation you have to remember for solving the problem, you have to remember efficiency of the Benetton cycle is 1 minus 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, where Rp is the pressure ratio of the cycle. And the normal, when the pressure ratio increases for constant value of gamma, the efficiency will increase. So, that is the simple conclusion. So, when the Rp value increases, the efficiency of the Benetton cycle will increase. And the red color band, so the variation of efficiency with respect to pressure ratio is shown in the figure. And the typical value of pressure ratio of the gas turbine engine is 5 to 20 normally. Now, we calculate the net work output during the Benetton cycle. So, W net work output equal to heat received per cycle minus heat rejected per cycle. So, MCP into T3 minus T2, that is the heat supplied or heat received, minus MCP into T4 minus T1. So, MCP is common term, we take it outside. So, T3 minus T4 minus T2 plus T1. So, we rearrange the terms. Now, in the equation, W equal to MCP is taken out. And in the first two terms, we take T3 outside. So, 1 minus T4 by T3 minus T2 in the T2 minus T2 plus T1. I take minus T1 outside. So, into 1 by T2 by T1 minus 1. So, the work done per cycle MCP into T3 into 1 minus T4 by T3 minus T1 into T2 by T1 minus 1. Now, for isentropic process, we have T3 by T4 equal to T2 by T1 equal to Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is Rp to the power Z. We take this gamma minus 1 by gamma as Z for our convenience for mathematical work. And now, we substitute here. So, W equal to MCP into T3 into 1 minus 1 by Rp to the power Z minus T1 into Rp to the power Z minus 1. Now, here work done is the function of mass, specific heat, T3, the temperature of the cycle after heat addition, T1, temperature of the cycle before the compression, and Rp is the pressure ratio. And the T3 is the maximum temperature in the cycle, and T1 is the minimum temperature in the cycle. And we have to calculate the maximum work output. So, for maximum work output, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to Rp and equal to 0. So, differentiating, so MCP, so T3, differentiating 1, it is 0, minus differentiating 1 by Rp to the power Z equal to Z into 1 by Rp to the power 2Z. So, differentiating, we take Rp to the power Z to the numerator, so that becomes Rp to the power minus Z. Differentiating Rp to the power minus Z equal to Z into Rp to the power minus Z minus 1. So, it becomes 2Z. So, Z into 1 by Rp to the power 2Z minus. So here minus T1 is a constant. Differentiating Rp to the power Z equal to Z into Rp. Rp equal to 1. Minus 1. Now, so this is equal to 0. So MCP is taken to the other side. That becomes 0. Z is also a common parameter. That is also dropped. So finally, T3 into 1 by Rp to the power 2 Z equal to T1. And rearranging, T3 by T1 equal to Rp to the power 2 Z, which is Rp to the power 2 into gamma minus 1 by gamma. So Rp, that is pressure ratio of the gas turbine cycle, optimum pressure ratio of the gas turbine cycle for maximum work output, T3 by T1 to the power gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1. This equal to T3 is the maximum temperature of the cycle. So T max by T minimum to the power gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1. So when the Rp pressure ratio is equal to T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1, the work output will be maximum. That is what the conclusion. And this equation you have to remember for all the examination, the competitive examination, this equation is very important. So the optimum pressure ratio is T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1. And the work output of the cycle, work output per unit mass, Cp into T3 minus T4 minus Cp into T2 minus T1 equal to Cp into T3 minus T4 minus T2 plus T1. And we have T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T4. So T4 equal to T3 T1 divided by T2. So rearranging, T4 equal to T3 into T1 divided by T2. And we substitute here for T4. So W equal to Cp into T3 into T3 minus T1 T3 by T2 minus T2 plus T1. Now for maximum work output, differentiate with respect to T2. So T3 is the maximum temperature that is fixed in the cycle. T1 is the minimum temperature fixed in the cycle. The only variable is T2, the intermediate temperature. We differentiate this equation with respect to T2 and it gives Cp into T3 is a constant dropped minus T1 T3 are constant, differentiating minus 1 by T2 equal to 1 by T square. So T1 T3 by T square minus T2 equal to 1 and T1 is a constant. So Cp into T1 T3 divided by T2 square minus 1 equal to 0. Or T1 T3 by T2 square equal to 1 or T2 equal to square root of T1 and T3. T1 into T3. Now we substitute this value. This is the optimum value of the temperature after compression. So T2 equal to square root of T1 into T3. Now you substitute in this equation for T2. So here we have to substitute for T2. So maximum work equal to Cp into T3 minus T1 T3. Divide by square root of T1 T3 minus T2 equal to square root of T1 T3 plus T1. So this becomes Cp into T3. So these two are combined 2 times of square root of T1 T3 plus T1. So this is going to be W max equal to Cp into square root of T3 minus square root of T1 whole square. Or the maximum work output equal to Cp into square root of T max minus square root of T minimum to the power 2. So, that is the maximum work output. And similarly, the maximum efficiency of the cycle, maximum efficiency of the Barrett-Tan cycle, and eta max equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, substituting for Rp, and this will become 1 minus square root of T1 by T3, which is equal to 1 minus square root of T minimum by T maximum. So, the maximum efficiency of the Barrett-Tan cycle equal to 1 minus square root of T minimum by T maximum. So, T maximum is the temperature at the outlet of the combustion chamber. Or T1 is the temperature, T minimum is the temperature at the entry of the compressor. So, if you know the temperature, entry temperature of the turbine and entry temperature of the compressor, you can calculate the work done and the efficiency of the cycle. And we have assumed that the process in the compressor and the turbine, they are isentropic. So there is no friction. So for isentropic process, the process is reversible and adiabatic. So there is no friction. Frictional losses are negligible. So we can assume that frictional losses are negligible, but practically we have to consider. So the friction will give some effect on the performance of the Barrett-Tan cycle. So, we have to consider the effect of friction. So, the effect of friction is increasing, changing the work input or work output. So, we will see. So, this is the Barrett-Ann cycle. So, 1, 2S, 3, 4S. This is the ideal cycle. So, 1 to 2S is the isentropic compression. 2S to 3 is the heat addition. 3 to 4S is the isentropic expansion. 4S to 1 is the heat rejection. So, because of the friction in the compressor, the work output, 2A, the temperature at the outlet of the compression process, that is increasing. So, 2S is shifted to 2A. Now, the heat addition process, real heat addition process, it starts from 2A and it is heated up to the point 3. There is no change in the point 3. Now because of the friction in the turbine, the 4.4, the temperature after expansion is shifted to 4A from 4S. Now, 4A is higher than 4S. Now, the expansion starts from 4A. Sorry, heat rejection starts from 4A. The heat output starts from 4A to 1. So, the heat rejection is more. Heat supply is less. Now, the efficiency of the Barrett-Ann cycle, now it becomes W net divided by Q supply equal to QS minus QR by Q supply. This is equal to 1 minus heat rejected by heat supply, 1 minus MCP into now real heat supply, actual heat supply is actual heat rejection, QR equal to heat rejection equal to Q MCP into T4A minus T1 and actual heat supply equal to MCP into T3 minus T2A. So, MCP is getting cancelled. So, this has become 1 minus T4A minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2A. Now, we know the inlet temperature for the compressor T1 and T3 value, T4A, T2A we have to calculate. But we can calculate using the isentropic expression, 2S we can calculate and 4S we can calculate. Now, we require another parameter to calculate 4A and 2A, that is what the turbine efficiency and compressor efficiency. And we take heat supplied equal to QS equal to MCP into T3 minus T2 and heat rejected equal to MCP into T4A minus T1, turbine work equal to MCP into T3 minus T4A and the compressor work equal to MCP into T2A minus T1 and efficiency of the cycle equal to WT minus WC divided by heat supply. And here to calculate the 4A, we have to define the turbine efficiency. So, turbine efficiency equal to actual work divided by the isentropic work. The actual work equal to MCP into T3 minus T4A divided by isentropic work equal to MCP into T3 minus T4S. So, MCP is cancelled. So, this will become T3 minus T4A divided by T3 minus T4S. And this 4S we can calculate from the isentropic relationship. So, from the definition of the turbine work, we can calculate T3 minus T4A. And similarly, we have to define the compressor efficiency. So, compressor efficiency now, isentropic work divided by actual work, because actual work will be more than the isentropic work in the case of compressor. So, MCP into T2S minus T1 divided by MCP into T2A minus T1. And this equal to T2S minus T1 divided by T2A minus T1. So, the T2A we can calculate from the value of compressor efficiency. And the turbine efficiency and the compressor efficiency, it is normally above 95% in the practical gas turbine power plant. So, we have to consider the effect of turbine efficiency and compressor efficiency or effect of friction on the overall performance of the gas turbine cycle or gas turbine power plant. So, we stop here and we have a reflection spot. So, from the previous discussion for the 20 minutes, we have to answer few questions here. So, the first question, the air standard Barrett-Ann cycle comprises of two constant volume processes and two constant entropy processes, two constant pressure process and two constant entropy process, two constant volume process and two constant pressure process, two constant volume process and two constant temperature processes. So, the correct answer. So, we have isentropic compression, constant pressure heat addition, isentropic expansion and constant pressure heat removal. So the correct option is two constant pressure process. So heat addition, heat removal, constant pressure process. Work input, compressor and turbine work, they are constant entropy, isentropic process. The answer is B. And the thermal efficiency of the air standard Brayton cycle in terms of pressure ratio and specific heat ratio is given by, there are four options given. So eta equal to 1 minus 1 by rp to the power gamma minus 1. Eta equal to 1 minus 1 by rp to the power gamma. C, option C, 1 minus 1 by rp to the power 1 by gamma. And option D, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So you take few seconds and guess the answer. From your notes, you can verify your notes and give the correct answer. So if you have selected D, you are correct. So the efficiency of Brayton cycle equal to 1 minus 1 by rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. And another question, the pressure ratio P2 by P1 of a gas power plant cycle corresponding to maximum work output for a given temperature limits of T minimum and T maximum will be. What is the P2 by P1 in terms of T minimum and T maximum? So, A, the option is A, T maximum T minimum to the power gamma by 2 gamma minus 1. Option B, T minimum by T maximum to the power 2 gamma by gamma minus 1. Option C, T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. And option D, T minimum by T maximum to the power gamma minus 1 by 2 gamma. So, the correct answer is option A, T maximum by T minimum to the power gamma by 2 into gamma minus 1. And these are all the books you can refer for further information. I have written a book on thermal engineering, you can refer to it. So, PK Nag, Engineering Thermodynamics, Senjal and Bowles, Engineering Thermodynamics, Rajput, Thermodynamics, and PL Belani by Thermal Engineering. So, you can refer to it. And I conclude with a quote from Dr. Abdul Kalam, dream is not which you see while sleeping, it is something that does not let you sleep. So you work hard to achieve whatever you want in your life. And these are all the books I published earlier. So design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machines. And also I have a YouTube channel where I upload the lecture notes, video lectures for the subject mentioned here. Also I upload the solution for gate question paper. So you may refer to it for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. So you subscribe the video so that you will get the alert for the latest videos. And you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for all your help and clarification. Thank you once again. We will meet again in the next lecture.